Hi, in this video I'm going to talk about how crowdfunding works. I'm going to show you a couple of examples how crowdfunding works and also give you a couple of tips if planning on crowdfunding a certain kind of project. So let's begin. Okay, when you're planning to crowdfunding project, there's a couple of things that you need to know. So I'm going to discuss these couple of things in this video, but I'm also going to show you a way to think about when you're investing in crowdfunding. So a couple of tips. Let's start with the platforms. On the internet, you have a lot of platforms that provide crowdfunding services. What you need to know is when people are using certain kind of crowdfunding platform that are recognized, the platform did the research on the project. You can assume that the project is legit, but don't always count in that, because there are people that are applying to put their project on a platform. So you need to figure out if you're going to invest in some project, make sure you know the details. And most of the details you will find on a platform, but you can also contact the director of the person that's responsible for the project. So what you need to know is when you're investing something, if you have $10,000 to invest in something, don't invest $10,000 on one project. Don't do that. That's stupid. What you need to do is look for 10 projects where you can invest $1,000. So you can spread the risk. That's one thing. Make sure that you know that the company of the project has a doomsday plan. That's how I call it. It's something that when everything goes wrong, what are they going to do? When there's no sales, what are they going to do? Yeah, for me, is if they don't have a doomsday plan, I'm not going to invest anything in that project. So what you need to know is, if you look at the project, make sure that they tell you what they're going to do when there is no profit, because it's your money. You're investing it. You expect return of your investment. If you do not do that, yeah. The thing is, it's your money. You're investing it. And because you're investing in it, you expect money back. And if they don't have a plan for when something goes wrong, then it's not worth investing in. Just spread your investment and make sure when you look at the project, make sure that they have a doomsday plan. When something goes wrong, what are they going to do? Because most crowdfunding projects will go wrong. Because most crowdfunding projects will go wrong because the business model that they're having doesn't meet the crowdfunding requirement. And that's why it goes wrong. So what you need to do is do your research. How can you use a crowdfunding platform? Just go on a platform, just look at different projects and see what suits you. Don't see where you can make a lot of profits, but make sure you choose a project that suits you, something that's value. The reason why I'm saying this is because a high profit can come and go, but it also brings a lot of risk. But sometimes if you choose something that's close to you, when something goes wrong, you will support the project until there is good time. And sometimes some projects take time for them to get profitable or not. Okay? So what you need to do is choose something that's value your value, choose a project that's value your value, and choose also a project that suits you. Another tip that I can give you is make sure you keep track of the project, because sometimes people invest it and they will look a year later at the project and they're going to be like, hey, my money is gone. So make sure you keep track of the project. Make sure that you are updated every time something happens in a project and in a company. So that's in a nutshell how crowdfunding works. If you have questions about crowdfunding or anything related to crowdfunding, feel free to contact me. See you in the next video. Infinite power.